Okay, so let's start the session, but during the session I would like to switch off my webcam because of the internet issue. But I agree. Digital means, sir, you can
more attractive. Tell me
what is it? Yes, more attractive. So nowadays 21st century technology is the most attractive part for the students, especially the youngest learners. Right? So digital, so if you start using a audio material, like for example, the good thing about the digital audio material means you can combine too many things. Digital means, sir, anything which you will create using a computer or any devices.
Okay, sir.
So, yeah, sir also said that. So, mixing it too many things. Like, for example, without a digital technology, it's very difficult to carry all the different abstract sounds, like for example, nature sounds, or if you want to, you know, explain about the ocean, or if you want to explain about something, about the forest, or anything. So if you want to explain it in your classroom, so you can't take the, or you can't create the same sound or audio in the classroom without this digital technology, right? So for example, because of digital only, I can able to mix veena sound, I can mix tabla sound or whatever, the keyboard sound, along with my voice. So it will be more effective, obviously. I hope all of you know that. Okay. So that is the second point. And yes, some of you said that sharing is easy, right? Along with the sharing, so the good thing about the digital is, the power of digital is, you can reuse it. For example, today, if you create some audio material, no need to create again and again when you need it, right? So you can, once you create any audio material, you can always reuse it whenever you want it. You can use it to share also. For example, if you want to share the same audio file with the Karnataka teachers, or if you want to share with some of your colleagues. So all those things, it's very easy and it's very capable to do with this digital audio materials, right? Will all of you agree with this point? Are any comments, anything you want to share?
Yes,
please,
sir.
Come to my country. Yeah. Also, the power of the digital is it's very easy to store also, right? So it can be audio, it can be a video, or it can be anything. Like if you want to write in a textbook, or if you want to create in a book. So if there is no digital, it's very difficult to create and store it. But because of the digital, so I can use it to store. Like I can create, I can talk 6 hours continuously. I can record it and I can simply save it in my mobile phone. Or I can store it in, nowadays I can store it in my even smart TVs also, right? So all these things are possible only from the digital. Okay, so if I come to language part, so many times audio resources will help us to correct our vocabulary. So for example, so if we keep talking and recording your own voice, and after some point, if you listen your own the audio materials, you will find out too many, you know, some corrections, or it's very easy to do it correct. Hello. I hope I'm audible to all of you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're audible, sir.
Okay. So, but before going to next part, anything else teachers wants to say? Any teachers? Many of the teachers are not able to join with the audio mode. I don't know. Prithvi sir, can you help some of them? So for example, there is, yeah, Banumati madam is trying to join. Yeah, please look at the users list and you can help accordingly. Thank you. Okay, any of the participants, you want to say something or anything, any comments?
The digital audio resource is especially very useful during this online teaching, sir.
Yes. Especially this pandemic, it's audio. Any digital material is very, very useful, right? So whether it is the audio material, whether it is the video material, but the good thing about the audio material is it's very easy to store or easy to share. But if it comes to video, if the size is too big or if the materials are, you know, the finding the right visuals in this pandemic is very difficult. Unless you are a, you know, some graphic creative link.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, it is better to conduct the classes from 6:30 to 7:30, sir, because when we go to school, no, sir, we will be returning back at that time.
Okay. But the thing is, 1 hour is not enough to do this course, madam, because we have designed only four sessions, and four sessions into 4 hours is, you know, it's very difficult to cover all these things. Also, it will very difficult for all of you to learn all these things. So what I will request is, instead of 6:30 to 7:30, we can do 6:30 to 8.
Okay, so, sir.
Yeah, that also I can check with all of you. At the end of this session, I will make in a small poll. So all of you can vote for it. All the agenda activities here. So for that, we have given a resources links also in this on the last column. So people can go through this links. And the second session, third session, fourth session. So there are four sessions in this course. And agenda is available on this page. But very, very important section is this course resources. So during the course or post the course or during the session or post the session, always all of you have to go through these sections. There is a section called technology resources. For example, after this today's session, if you find any difficulty to practice offline, so always you can go through this section and you can download all these pages. Okay. So there is a Audacity handout. So if you miss something or if you face some network issues during the session, so always offline, you can always go through this page to get all those things. And there are other audio repository links also available here. So this I will explain when it comes to the music part on session thing. Okay. So apart
the
from
same that, may be shared in the WhatsApp
group. Yeah. The same link I have shared it in a WhatsApp group, but many of you, I don't know whether you have read it or not. That's why I'm just quickly going through this sections. Okay. Thank you. Yeah. So online resources, basically these are the different audio repositories. Same like a YouTube. YouTube is for mainly for the video repository. The same way these are some of the open audio repositories. There is a website called Free Sound. There is a website called Soundable and Ben Sound. Always I prefer Ben Sound to download some different kind of music because Ben Sound is completely, it's a free and open source, means OER resources. Look at here. So this is a Ben Sound website and all these are audio materials. So if you want to download any of these background music or music, you can just simply by clicking on this download option, you can download it to your computer or to your smartphone also. Okay. So these are some of the audio repositories. And along with that, we have given a link for the reading materials. So whatever the Guru sir has covered in the session, in the Krashan session, all the resources are available under this reading material. For example, there's a page called Krashan Hypothesis on our website. So this is a Krashan Hypothesis website. People can go through this to get a more idea about the session. And there is a NCF 2005 position paper is also available here. Okay, so, and if you come to this section, see, there is a section called audio resources created by a last batch participants. For example, you are the, I think, fourth batch in CELT. And all the previous batches have participated in this audio course. And some of them have created a very great audio materials. So, for example, if you go through these links, you will get an idea about the resources which created from the previous batch participants. So always you can go through this. Because of this, these are OER. Always, if you find anything which is useful for your classroom teaching, feel free to download it also, because all these audio materials are free and open source. All these materials are OER, open education resources. That's why people can download, they can comment on it. So all these things, you can do it. Okay. And very, very important, also expected from the participant, is the assignment. Okay. So as per the course completion, each participant need to be created in audio resources. Right. So from today onwards, you are going to select one topic. It can be a poem, it can be a phrase, or it can be any great speech or any moral stories you can take. Anything which you would like to create in an audio material. So take a one topic, and then what you will do is, you throughout these four sessions, you will create an audio material. Okay. So whichever topic you will select, you will create an audio resources, and you will submit that as an assignment. So for submitting your assignment, here there's a link. Click here to submit your created audio file. It's assignment. And very important note point is, so only participants who successfully complete the course by submitting their audio resources through the above link will get a certificate. Okay. The certificate will come from the RIC and IT for Change. This is not the same certificate which you will get from the CLT. This is the other this is a different certificate. Is that clear? Any doubts? Anything you want to ask? I'm not able to see the public chat because I'm in a web page now. So I request all the teachers to come to mic and talk if you have anything.
Yes, sir. Yes. I have joined recently. We understood your point.
Yes, okay, now. Okay. Yeah, thank you. Very important is, yeah, because many times the people will join the session, people will join first and second session, then they will drop out. So those teachers, those participants will not get any certificate from this course. Okay,
sir,
yes, go ahead.
Sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, whether we have to
don't do like that, sir.
Do one audio recording or throughout the four classes, four audio recordings,
yes.
Sir?
No. Throughout the four sessions, you will work on only with the one audio.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Sir. Yes,
because for example, if you look at my agenda, in the first session, we will teach you only how to record, how to save, how to export. And if you come to the second section, we will teach you how to edit that recorded audio. For example, you know, in the first session, if you recorded some story, and in that, if you want to remove something or if you want to add something, which you have missed it while recording. So all those things you will do it in the second webinar session. The third session, the following session, you will try to find out some best background music for your the recorded audio file, and you will try to combine those two. The background music, ambient sounds, and the different things you will combine with your recorded audio. Then in the last session, we will teach you some of the few advanced things in Audacity. Is that clear? So this is what we have structured our course.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So today you will only focus on how Audacity will work, how to open, how to save. Yes, go ahead, sir. Yeah, please go ahead. Some of your training. Okay, Ram Reddy, sir. You want to say something?
Sir. Audacity is laptop lo open jason, sir.
వెయిట్ చేయండి సార్ నేను చెప్తాను
ఇప్పుడు
ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయాలి ఇంత సో సారీ మై తెలుగు ఇస్ నాట్ ప్రాపర్ బేసికలీ ఐఎమ్ కన్నడిగా బట్ సిన్స్ ఐ హావ్ స్టార్టెడ్ వర్కింగ్ విత్ తెలంగాణ టీచర్ ఫ్రమ్ లాస్ట్ 5-6 ఇయర్స్ ఐ జస్ట్ స్టార్టెడ్ స్పీకింగ్
మాట్లాడుతున్నారు సార్
థ్యాంక్ యూ బట్ మెనీ టైమ్స్ ఇన్స్టా యు నో ఐ విల్ మిస్ ద సింగులర్ అండ్ ప్లూరల్ మీకు మీరు నీకు మీరు బట్ ఇఫ్ ఎనీబడి వాంట్స్ టు ఆస్క్ ఎనీ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆర్ యూ వాంట్ టు టాక్ ఇన్ తెలుగు ఫీల్ ఫ్రీ టు కమ్ అండ్ టాక్ దేర్ ఇస్ నో ఇష్యూ ఓకే సో లెట్స్ stop this.
Sir, about assignment.
Yes, ma'am. Go ahead.
What kind of a things, like a poem means overall poem, we have to record it and after that we have to edit
you,
it off?
We'll come to that point. No problem. So if you take a poem, basically we are expecting at least a 2 minutes audio. It can be a poem or it can be a full poem, or you want to create audio only for the part of that poem. That is up to you. But your assignment at the end of this course, you will create an audio material which should have a minimum 2 minutes of
recording. Okay.
Yes, recording. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Sir, good evening, sir.
Good evening, sir.
Sir, only we listen the class now?
You are going to create also.
At the same time, while you are teaching, we also create the source.
No. When I'm teaching or when I'm showing something on the screen, just look at the screen, note down all the points. But every 10 minutes or after every two features after I show, then I'll give you time to practice.
Just you teach some first subject you teach, then we have to practice.
Yes.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, sir. Okay, so let's start with the installation.
That means both the apps should be parallelly on.
Sorry?
Audacity as well as the Blue Button. The apps Audacity should be on.
Yes.
Like
Audacity and the browser. Yes. Because Big Blue Button you are using through the browser. Yes. So basically, browser and the Audacity should be open.
Yes.
Yeah, but when I'm teaching, fine. don't open Audacity. Only be in a browser, look at it, and note down all the points. Then I will give a practice time to all of you. Okay. So yeah, let's start with the installation. I'm going to share my screen again. This time I'll share my entire. Okay, so if you look, come to my course page. So as I said, there is a link to Audacity handout. If you click on this, it will open it. Okay, so this is the Learn Audacity handout page. So apart from the installation, there is a section called Working with the Application. So why I am showing is this, even after the session, when you are practicing offline, like before coming to the next session, you have to select your topic, you have to work on your audio material. So during that time, if you find any difficulty for using the Audacity, always you can refer this Learn Audacity page. Okay. I'll request my colleague Prithvi sir to share this link in a WhatsApp group as well as in the public chat so that people can go through this later. Okay. So yeah, if you come to the Working with the Application, just look at here, obtaining audio from the different resources. And there is a section called Recording with Audacity. For example, if some of you are facing issues to record audio file on the Audacity, people can come to this section and this will tell you how to open Audacity. Okay. So, and how to start your recording, how to save this, the recorded audio, everything it will show you step by step with the screenshot. If you look at my handout here, so for each and every steps, there is a screenshot. Okay, so this is our manual for Audacity. Since I have already installed Audacity in my computer, I'm just directly, I'll open the Audacity. But if some of you have faced any issues, please follow this installation instruction step by step so that you will install. I hope all of you have installed this plugin also, this section. How many of you have installed this plugin, MP3 plugin?
Is there any link?
Yeah, there is a link. Yes. So if you need to install this. So this is a link. So I'll just quickly show you how to do this. No problem. Nothing. Yeah, it's very important, but also not important in this session. So you may need required in a session two. Okay. So this plugin along with Audacity. So after you install Audacity, there is a plugin here. Yeah. So I'll click on this. It will open a driver link. Google Drive link. Here there is a download option. So after you download this lame v.3.993, so this is a file name. So after you download this, just double click and install this along with Audacity. Okay, this is not a separate application. Okay, so you will not get any application icon on your screen. It is just an addition plugin for your Audacity. That means after you install this, it will sit with the Audacity application. Is that clear?
Kindly share the link once again, sir. That link.
Yeah, same. Yeah, we will share it. But anyway, that's the same installation page only. You go through that. At the bottom, there is a note. But anyway, we'll do that. No problem. Okay. But basically, this plugin will help you to import or export your MP3 audio files. That's why it is required from the session 2. Sorry. So since I am using a Ubuntu, so if I want to open a Audacity, I have to go to application, sound and video, Audacity. But since all of you are using a Windows computer, if you want to open a Audacity, either you have to click on the icon which will come on your desktop, double click on the Audacity icon on from the desktop, then it will open. Otherwise, the another option is go to the search option at the bottom or a start menu, and then from there you can search Audacity application. Now, what about now?
Yes.
Okay, fine. So, yeah, I'll just repeat what I said now. So after you open Audacity application, always you will come to this page. So this is our home page on the Audacity application. So for today's session, I will just introduce only three parts. Okay. So one is the editing area. So this is our editing area. Right now, if you look at my editing area, it's completely empty. So this is our editing area. So right now it is empty because I have not yet imported or I have not yet recorded any audio material. That's why it is looking empty. It's like a plain sheet. And if I want to record anything, there is a recording option on the top. So this is the recording button. So if I want to record something, just I want to click on this button. So if I click on this button, it will start my tracking. Whatever I'm speaking now, so it is recording. And whenever I was not talking, so just look at the cursor. So it is not yet recorded in this part. It is completely empty because I have not had spoken in this area. Okay, the same way you can record it n number of audio files using this Audacity. Okay, so after you listened, if you don't want this track or if you don't want this audio file, always you can use this small into mark on this. I hope all of you are able to see this close button here. Not the application close button. I'm just talking about this track. So this is one track. So whatever I'm showing now, so this is my one track. And at any time, if you don't want this track or if you don't want this audio, always you can use this close button. If I click on this close button, the audio will be removed from your track. Is that clear? Should I show it one more time?
Clear.
Yeah, okay, so if I click on this, yes, always sir. Whenever you click on this record button, this red button, the recording will be start. And see, if you look at my cursor, so it is showing the wavelength because I'm talking. If I keep quiet, it won't record because, so this is the way the Audacity will show you whether the audio is recorded or not. Okay, and at any case, if you don't like to add this part or you want to remove this audio track, always you can use this close button. This way you can close it. Okay, so I have one small tips to all of
is
you.
Is it automatically saved, sir?
No, it is not. It was not saved. It was just in a draft base, but I removed it from my track because I don't want
that. How to save it, sir?
I will show you. I will come to that point, sir. I will go step by step. Don't worry. I will show you everything. Okay. So, yeah. So, this is for recording. And I hope all of you get this. This is your editing area. Right now, it is empty. But before going to record any kind of audio in Audacity, you have to take care of your input volume. Okay, input volume is very, very, very important. More than any technical skills, especially working with audio, your input volume, if you are good with your mic, if you are good with your the input volume level, everything, then definitely your audio will be, you know, 90% your work will be done through while recording only. Then small fine-tuning things you can do it with Audacity, but especially if you spend more time with the recording and the way you speak, the way you pronounce the letters or the voice modulation, everything is a matter. So that is the most important part when you are going to create an audio material. Okay, so my suggestion is, before going to record any part, so there is a small monitor button here. You'll be able to see this, my cursor moving here. Click to start monitoring.
Yes.
Yeah.
You can see.
So
that.
If you look at here, there are two different monitor tools. One is what is this? Any idea? Can anyone tell me what is this? What is this? What is
microphone.
This? Yes. Microphone. The first one is a microphone.
Second one is
The second one is the speaker. Okay. Speaker right now, don't worry, because speaker is the output. Like after you record something, if you want to play, you will see this, whether it is playing or not. But when you are recording something, when you are going to record new things, always take care of your recording level, that is microphone level. So what I will do is, I request all of you to do the same thing. So always you click on the click to monitor tool, then it will start whether your mic is working or not. If you look at the monitor toolbar, whenever I speak, it is just reaching, you know, minus 12 dB something, right? Will you be able to see the color bar?
Yeah, we can see that, sir. But yeah. Can we use of earphones with the microphone?
Sorry?
Mobile headset. The mobile microphones.
Ah.
Mobile headset are there. So can we use that? Because they are available everywhere.
Can use it. Yeah, you can use mobile headphone, you can use a system headphone also. But my suggestion,
everybody has is, professional mics, no?
Yeah, I know. Yeah, even I am also not using a professional headphone. I'm just using some normal headphone. Okay, so my suggestion is, along with this green color, whenever it's a red color, see, when I start speaking loudly, hello, hello, hello. So sometimes if you look at my wavelength, sometimes it will hit the red color, right? So red means it is very loud. It is not a good, it is not a healthy record. Also, if it is very light green color, that is also not healthy. So always when you're speaking or when you're talking or when you're recording something in Audacity, especially take care of this. You know, my suggestion always minus 24 to minus 12 dB is the good audio. Or minus 6 is the maximum. It should not cross the minus 6 dB. If it is crossing a minus 6 dB, means your audio is too loud, and also that is a problem later. Is that clear, all of you? So I will stop now, okay?
Yes.
I'm not going to record anything. What I will do is, I will stop now, all of you. Just open your Audacity application. And all of you cross-check your the click monitoring tool. Not the speaker monitoring tool, the mic monitoring tool. Please, all of you, just do some testing and then come back quickly. Please, all of you. Before going to my Audacity screen, I would like to change my slide here. So if you look at my slide, so I have made a small checklist to record any audio. So all these things, if you take care of, before recording, so obviously 90% of your audio, it will give in a good output. So for example, like when you are choosing a topic, or when you know that you are going to record an audio on any particular topic, So my request is always write down the script in your notebook or anywhere. Like some of you, if you are comfortable with your MS Word or anywhere, notepad, please write down the script in detail. In detail means like when you want to speak loud or when you want to speak with a less volume, sorry. So all those things, small things also, please note down in your script so that it will help you to when you are recording your audio. Okay. So that is my first tips for the audio creation. Then obviously most of us, it's very difficult to find out very lessy noise place, especially since all of us, sitting at a home and trying to find out some less noise place is very difficult. But try to find out at least, some small closed place where you can record your audio. Especially if you sit at a big classroom or if you sit at a big, hall or something, duplex house. Always it will give an echo, extra echo sound, which, it is not good for your audio. So that is my second suggestion. Always find out less noisy and the smaller room. Always smaller room is better. And yes, this is my common suggestion. Also common mistake when any of the, whether teacher or anybody, when they are creating, they will do this mistake. So when you are going to record something, always try to switch off the other tech, digital, other any electronic devices. It can be a TV or it can be a fan or air conditioner, anything. So you will feel that you are not going to record that audio, but technically the microphones, many of the microphones are very strong. So it will try to record even though if you are sitting at a room and your living room TV is on. So sometimes that sound also will record it in your audio. So try to switch off all the devices before going to the record. And if you are not able to find out some close place, if there are too many windows or a doors, at least try to use some thick curtains. Okay, just for the recording. I'm not talking about, for all the four sessions, just for a recording part. After you started editing, then there's no need required all these things. Okay, so then very, very common mistake and very important thing is this last point. So last point is the most common mistake which all of us do. So which is that, when we are eager to do some audio creation, so we'll keep our mic very close to our mouth. So that what it will do is, it, along with our vocal, so it will start recording our breathing, the sound and other noises also. Okay. So try to avoid keeping your mic very close to your mouth. I'm suggesting at least 10 to 15 centimeters, just keep it away from your mouth. Is that clear? This slide, any doubts, any comments? If you follow some of these suggestion, definitely you will get a very good audio output.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Go ahead.
So just now I have recorded, sir, but I didn't get how to listen my voice.
I will come to that part now. I'm not, oh. Yeah, I will come to that. How to play, how to save, that part I'm not to cover. Yeah, I will come. Okay, thank you.
Mr. Rakesh, do you recommend a decent microphone for this recording?
Yes, depending on the which device you are using. For example, if you are using a desktop or if you are using for example, first I will finish the desktop part. If people are using a desktop, that means the big screen computer, always I prefer use the backport mic jacks. Don't use the front part of the pins. I hope all of you understand what I'm saying. Especially in your computer lab, in your school lab. So all of you will have desktops. So in that, in both side, in the front and back, both side, there will be a microphone jacks. So my suggestion, always use the backside because that will directly, it will connect to your board, the computer. So it will give a good audio. That is first part. The second part is, if you are using a laptop or if you are using, the small, medium budget laptops, always try to use an additional microphone or something. You can use small mobile headphone also, if there is. But please use the additional microphone.
Okay. Yeah, that is what exactly I'm asking about. Do you recommend a particular brand or something? A decent
particular brand, I don't...
Less.
Yeah. Always the brands will keep updating. Quality. So what I am right now, I'm using is the Sennheiser. So that is, I'm happy with this brand.
Sennheiser.
Okay. And the model.
Okay.
So which I'm using. So this is recently I purchased it for around 1,200 rupees something. And this is, I hope all of your, my audio is very clear. I hope, I don't know.
Yeah, it is very clear. Is it headphones come yeah, microphone?
Yes, yes. Okay. It's a headset okay. with the microphone. I will just try to show that. This is what I am using. It's a smaller one and it's very lightweight. Even if I keep this, if I, you know, using from long time,
yes, yes.
It's very lightweight.
Okay. Good, good. Yes, thank you, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So if you don't want to buy a new thing, at least you try to use your smartphone, headphone or something. That is what my suggestion. Okay. Yeah. So I'll quickly try to go through this checklist. So always try to use, yeah, this is what I said. Many times people will, you know, take care of their headphones speaker part, the both side speaker part, but we will neglect most of the time with the jack. So jack is very, very important. Even if you are getting a good audio from your headphone, that is because of your jack is good. So jack is very, very important because that is the where we will connect the device. So please, going forward at least, try to take care of both speaker as well as your pin, the headphone pin. Always keep it very safe. Okay. Yeah. So, yeah, we can start it now. I'll just start again. I'll start sharing my screen now. And we'll come back to Audacity. Is my audio is okay? Able to listen perfect, my audio?
Sir.
Hello? Okay. Yeah. Now I will start. I will show you how to do the recording first. So as I said, so this is a recording button. Once you click on this, so it will start recording whatever you talk. Okay. So even if you want to record something which is playing from your TV or something, just keep your microphone or keep your system near to your TV or wherever the output is coming. Then it will start recording your the music or the audio part. Okay, whenever you want to stop, always use this stop button. Look at my cursor here. This is a stop button. I'm going to click on this to stop the audio. Okay, there is a two different part. One is the pause and one is the stop. So pause is just for a time being. For example, like when I'm reading out some stories, if I miss something or if I want to refer some other thing, I can stop for time being and then I can continue recording. But the stop button is, it is not like that. So pause is for the time being, but stop button is when you click on the stop button, the complete recording will stop. That means your audio recording is finished. So I just clicked on the stop button. So that means my audio is, this is what I want to record. Just I will try to play this audio. So if you want to play this audio in Audacity, not only this audio, any audio, you always use this play button. This is a play button. So if I click on this play button, it will start.
Start recording whatever.
Yeah, it is playing, and also if you look,
if you want to record,
sorry, just look at this now. When I was recording, here the green color was coming, right? When I am speaking, but when I start playing, so this speaker part is showing.
And if you want to record something which is playing from.
So this way you can play, you can stop. So when you are playing audio, if you want to stop, always use the stop button. Okay. Now I will show you how to save this file. Please all of you look at the screen very carefully. This is the filing, saving a file is same as like a MS Office or any other application which you are already familiar. But I'm just repeating how to save this file. All of you please look at here. So two tips for saving the file. Before go to file and save option, you should make sure that you clicked on the stop button, not on the pause button. Okay, click on the stop button, then go to file, then save project, and again go to save project. Please, all of you, don't do any practice parallelly. I'm just showing the steps. Please note down, and then I will give a practice to all of you. Save project. Save project. And it is just giving a warning window. You just look at the pop-up window. It is saying warning. Warning is that save project is for an Audacity project. Yes. Not an audio file. For an audio file that will open in other apps, you should use a export option. Yes. So what it is saying is, I'm just quickly explaining what the warning is saying is. So we are just going to save this as a file, not as audio. Okay. So to save as an audio, we should use a export option, not an save option. There is an export option, but this I'm not going to teach in our today's session. I will show it in next session, but save project is enough for today's session. So the difference between the export and the save is, the save project is like it's just in a file. Okay. So for example, after a few days or after a couple of days, when you feel that you want to change something in your audio file, or you want to add something, or you want to remove something from your existing file, these project files are important. But the same thing, once you finished all your work, like for example, at the end of this course, I will ask you to submit your audio file. In that case, what you have to submit is, you have to go to the file export and you have to submit that file. Okay, export is just a finished product. Save project is a half-edited file. Like future, if you want to change something, if you want to do something, then this project file is important. Is that clear? You can confirm in a chat window also. But I'll request all of you, please confirm. Okay, great. Surya Prakash sir said yes. What is it? Yes. Swarnalata madam. Okay, sir. Thank you. Okay, fine. Great. Thanks for all your confirmation. Okay, let's come back to here. Okay, I'm not at save the file. I was just reading the warning window. So I'm okay with this warning. I will just click on OK. And now this will give the same window. Like all of us usually see this window, right? Give the file name for this. So for example, this is not my actual audio file. It's a dummy testing. So I'll naming as well. So I'll give it dummy testing. And I want to save it on my desktop, so that I will select a desktop from my left side window here. And this is my file name. And the file extension, the extension always it will be AUP, because it's a project file, so that it will save it in a Audacity project file format. So I'm going to save on this. So this way I can save my file. Now I will show you how the file will look. Here, look at my files here. This is the first file, and along with that, there is one folder has created. So I would like to explain about these two. So one is the project file, which is all of you, I already explained that. So this is just showing as a file, text file. Along with that, there is one supporting folder also will be there. So don't delete any either of these. So if you delete, for example, if you delete this file, this folder will not, you can't use it in Audacity. The same way, if you delete this folder and if you keep only this file, then this file also will not work, because all your file, the recorded content, everything, it will keep inside this folder. And that link will be in this folder file. Okay. So whenever you do the save project option, always it will create basically two files. One is the file, project file, and the data file, data folder, sorry. This way you can save your audio. Any doubts on saving a file, or any doubts on save or export difference? I will also show you quickly. No, sorry, I will show you export. Yeah, but for the safer side, I will show you export also. and I will show you what is the difference and how the look also you will find any difference. So for example, this time I will go to file. Instead of save project, I will do the export option. And I will go to export as MP3. Same way, it is asking some name and other things. I've already given a dummy testing. This file also I will test, save it on my desktop. Now, if you look at my file extension, what is this extension? MP3, right? So MP3 means it's a final exported audio file. So now if I export this, it is asking to enter all the detail. I mean, who is the creator, what is the file name, and what genre it is, everything. So people can enter this, or else you just simply skip on that. Okay, now I'll come back to here. So I just also save this as a export. Look at the three different files here. So these two are one when you do the save project, and when you export this, this will come. So this export file, I can share it in my WhatsApp group. I can share it in email. I can share it through anywhere. Like I can transfer to my phone also. But these two files will not play without the Audacity application. Okay, I hope all of you are clear. Andariki Arthamayindi Anta Bhavastan. Something. Okay. So
Arthamayindi sir.
Yes, sir. Arthamayindi sir.
Thank you, man.
But when we are trying to save it on the desktop, a folder, you said a folder is being created parallelly, right?
Yes. When you do the save project, always it will create an additional folder.
But it only saves
the data file. Sorry?
I don't see the folder.
Okay, maybe do it quickly because we have only 5 minutes now because I want to
When we have saved, you asked us to try opening it again, open with, right, sir?
Yes, open with Audacity.
Open with, when we say that, it recommends that apps in which you want to open.
Mm.
But I don't see the Audacity here, the recommended apps. What to do now?
Okay, then go to the other, at the bottom, there is an option, okay. No? Open with a more or something.
I'm looking at it. Look for other apps in the store. It is showing all other apps, but I don't see the Audacity icon at all. What to do?
Okay, no. Okay, so there is another option. You just look at the screen. I hope my screen is also.
Simply, shall I drag it into that?
You can drag and drop it, or you just go to file and open it. Go to file and open and browse it.
Fine.
So let's come back to Audacity now. All of you look at the screen. And now I will show you how to remove the existed audio track and how to open a new file. So for example, if you want to close this, if you don't want this, always, as I said, you can click on this small into mark to remove, right? So if you click on this, the entire track will be removed from your audio file. And the same way, if you want to create a one more audio, or if you want to create a one more, open a one more Audacity window, always go to file, and there is an option called new. So if I click on this, so my old Audacity window also will be there. And along with that, I will get one more new Audacity screen here. So this way you can open n number of Audacity window, okay, until your system's exit. So that's why I'll not suggest these things. Only if you want to work with up to two Audacity window, I'll suggest, but don't open more than two Audacity windows because your system will start hanging. So it will start something. The hardware is not good. Okay, so let's come back again here. So I showed you how to do this. And there's within the track, like if you look at this, this is one track. Even though there are two different lines here, Any idea why it is showing it two lines? Any guesses? Like, because even I have recorded only once, it is showing it two track, like
there like are two lines.
No, madam.
No, it has idea. Two channels.
It's a good thought. It's a good thought, but it's not as a backup.
It has two channels. Stereo.
Yes, exactly. You are right, sir. So, all of you, if you observe any of your music systems, or especially when people are listening audio or any music file with the headphone, so many of you are, you know, if you observe that, so sometimes the audio will come in the one speaker and the music will come in the another speaker, right? Did anyone feel this? Like, anyone experience this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, right. So especially, again, if you know, any of you are playing a movie with your headphone, sometimes if the car is moving from left to right, the sound will also move the same direction. And sometimes when you're playing a old songs, you know, some veena, tabla sound will come in one place, or male voice will come in the left speaker, female will come on the right speaker. Like that, there will be a different effects, right? So that is called left and right, okay, channel. Since you have a two speakers, so you will have a two channels. If you have a five speakers, 5.1 woofer, that is a five channel. So like that, so people nowadays, you know, there is a technology called using a five channels also, but so in Audacity, unfortunately, you can use only two channels. So one is the left speaker part and one is the right speaker part. For example, if you look at here, so this is one is the left speaker part and another in the right speaker part. But both are same audio. So if you look at my audio, so even though if you use a headphone, my both side will come the same audio part because the wavelength are same. Is that clear? Why it is coming two lines? So this is like a two channels, left and right side speakers. So for different speakers, for different channels, we can use. But in this course, we are not going to use this level of editing, the channel wise, but there is an option. Is that clear? Yeah, so same way, if you record your audio using your mobile phone or mobile through the mobile or any other audio devices, that will create only mono channel. Mono channel means only single line. I will show you that also. What I will do, I will change my channel to mono. Right now it is a stereo, but I will change it to mono recording. And look at the screen now. Don't see this. I'm going to create one more recording here. Just look at that part. I'm recording audio now. So, but if you look at my audio recording, right now it is showing only one line. Look at that. Okay. I hope all of you are able to see this part. Now, if you look at my track, so it is recording only one line. That is a mono channel. So this way, I can create an audio in a different way, but both are, technically, there is a difference. Okay, please listen carefully. Technically, there are a lot of difference, but for the listeners, for the normal users, you don't feel or you don't see any difference in this mono and stereo. Is that clear? So why I am showing or why I am explaining this mono and stereo is, so since it's already 7:30 now, what I will do is I'll stop my screen sharing. I'll come back to this. So what all of you have to do is, you have to select one topic before coming to the next session. All of you, please, if you want to note down, you can note down, or else I will request Prithvi sir to type it in a shared notes or chat, public chat. So first thing is, all of you, make sure you have installed Audacity and it is working in your computer. That is the first part. Second part is, all of you should select a topic. It can be a speech, it can be a poem, or it can be a story, or it can be your own story, whatever audio you are going to create. Okay, it can be poem also. But basically, your audio recording, it should have minimum at least 1.5 to 2 minutes length. This is the second part. Sorry, third part. One is the Audacity installation is first point. Second point is, you have to select a topic. And third part is, you have to record audio. You have to record and you have to come with that recording file before coming to the next session. Is that clear? These three things?
Sir,
I will come to that point, sir. The fourth point is, the last one is, whatever topic you are going to select, that you have to fill it in a Google form. I will share the link in a Google form. All of you listen carefully. After you selected topic,